Now it's time to meet the nominees for the top play of the week. And here they come, some awesome plays presented by MTD Products in Shelby. And at numero uno, how about the heart of Ohio snatching the heart of the Golden Knights fans, because Northmore unbeaten no more, folks, thanks to Tyler Johnson drag racing his way down the gridiron to score Centerburg a major road win. Speed kills Hayden Gray.
Yeah, you know, and Marcus Cortez is one of the guys he beats on this play after the great field vision and able to kind of make a Connor Morris type one cut getting up the field, and he beat Marcus Cortez out to the end zone. That's not an easy guy to beat, and this was a huge momentum builder for them and just kept the electricity up for them all night as they beat Northmore.
At play two, how about Connor Morris? And you're going to note here he's going to start in a three-point stance, and then he's going to get up and do his dance all over St. Paul, leaving laundry and egos just pillaged along the way. This run broke things open for Crestview, who rode Morris to a long-awaited win over their rivals. That play was awesome.
Makes the defender look silly, like he's skating on ice, Brian. Puts his foot in the ground, turns on the afterburners, but is not able to outrun the defense. But he did it all night long. There was a couple runs like this, but this one is going to get the top play nominee.
Cougars are now 9-0. Well, guys, they teach quarterbacks to throw the ball where only their man can get it, but this is kind of like tossing a cork into a bottle. Precision passing at its finest from Lester to Steinmetz for a beautiful score.
How many times have we seen this year from Peyton Lester? We saw him at Northmore drop one in the double coverage right in the corner of the end zone. We've seen him do it here. He does it almost every week.
Well, in the game of football, it's not always recommended to attack double coverage, but hey, when you've got Harding's Wesley Stokes, sometimes two men just ain't enough.
Brady Winks sends a cannon right over the top of the defense, and Wesley Stokes, showing off the grown man strength, mosses two defenders and sends them to the turf. These two guys have been a dynamic duo really all season long.
Just wow, G-Man, I think is the best way that you can put it. President scored a huge win, 23-21 at Clear Fork. Next up is going to be the Galloping Ghost, a.k.a. Corbin Toms, who you're going to see, he's going to make like a reindeer on Christmas, folks, dashing all the way into the end zone storm. And I just love here the last couple of plays. It just like, what? Keeps his footing and into the zone.
Yeah, turning off the afterburners right there. 70 yards. I mean, he can outrun a bunch of players like that. I'm not even sure I could walk that far, let alone run. So big yards there from Corbin Toms, and the Lucas Cubs are rolling.
I love how Storm's always just comparing his athletic ability to these guys on our phenoms and top plays. Good stuff right there. 70 yards into the end zone for the Cubs, who would knock off Fort Loramie 31-8. Total team performance. But that was the best play we saw. Well, Orville, they cooked up some Redbird stew on Friday. Here's Tyler Schroeder feasting Sawyer Hampshire, getting on his circus act down the sideline. Look at him as he tightropes all the way for about 10 yards and into the zone.
Yeah, you just look at him. It looks like, okay, he's going to get a good gain. He's going to get the first down. But wait, he's still in bounds? How's he still in bounds all the way to the end zone? Just what, one broken tackle here down the sideline, two broken tackles here, and then he turns on the afterburners. Tutty. Four of them for him on the night.
Redbirds win big, 41-14 at Loudonville. And folks, not all takeaways are created equal, because when they happen in the red zone, they sting just a little bit more. And here's Andre Hill taking food off the table from River Valley, and he's even got Vikings falling all over themselves as he races the other way. Storm embarrasses them.
Yeah, River Valley was driving on this possession too, and Andre Hill with a big defensive stand saying, not today, not going to score on me, gets the interception, and has a pretty healthy return as well.
The Whippets would go on to take the dub thanks to big plays like this, 47-20 over River Valley. Well, folks, those are your nominees. Comment your vote to decide this week's winner below.